Well, Hurricane Ian is really what's on everyone's mind today. The latest insured loss estimates run between $55 all the way up to $75 billion, and that's inclusive of flood-related losses, including those through the National Flood Insurance Program. And a couple billion of that actually is going to come through the catastrophe bond market as well. So there's a pretty big hit all around. And on the higher end of that, it potentially becomes the most costly natural disaster in United States history, superseding Hurricane Katrina in terms of insured losses. So I'm not quite sure it'll actually get there at the end of the day. We tend to actually see somewhat of an overestimation, I think, in the early stages of these events. But it's going to take several months to get to the final bottom line of this. The other part of the tragedy, of course, is there was an enormous amount of uninsured loss. So typically, when we look at events like this, let's say we wind up at a $60 billion sort of loss, we could estimate easily that total economic losses wound up being in the $100 to $120 billion range. So a lot of uninsured loss there, and therein lies the rub. That huge gap between the lack of insurance and those losses that are actually insured, unfortunately, is a breeding ground, a veritable swamp of trial lawyers waiting to sue the insurance industry, who will claim that certain losses, in fact, should have been covered and the insurer denied the claim. And this could be anything from the old wind versus water litigation along the lines of what we saw in the wake of Hurricane Katrina back in 2005, 6, 7, and to a lesser degree, Sandy, which occurred back in 2012. But we have layered on top of this the very unusual situation in Florida that predates Ian. And that's the fact that its market, its homeowners insurance market, was utterly dysfunctional even before the first winds of Ian came anywhere close to the shores of Florida. Even prior to Ian, six smaller insurers had already become insolvent, and that was entirely due to trial lawyers run amok associated with the so-called assignment of benefits problem. You layer one of the largest natural disasters ever to occur in United States history on top of a market that is already dysfunctional, rendered such by trial lawyers. And mind you, we're not talking about a small market here. We are talking about the Florida homeowners insurance market, which is likely the second largest, maybe third largest in the United States by total premium volume today. So we're not talking about a minor issue here. So the reverberations from Ian will be heard loud and clear far beyond Fort Myers, far beyond Tallahassee, and in fact, will go all the way to Washington and around the world, because I think it will prompt not only some legislative and regulatory changes within the state of Florida itself, but potentially the silver lining from all of this is that the devastation from Ian, contrasted with the better performances of the more recent buildings in certain communities in Florida, could certainly serve as a springboard for a more productive conversation about how to build more resilient communities in those areas where we know it is not a matter of if, it's just a matter of when you will be hit by an event like this in the future. The other silver lining from this is the fact that that despite the economic instability that we're seeing around the world and the financial market volatility we're seeing in the United States, years of near record catastrophe losses and coming out of COVID, the property casualty insurance industry remains strong, stable, sound, and secure before, during, and after Ian. And so that's a message I really think will resonate around the world.